Actually, what is logistics? Logistics means actually the process of planning and controlling the entire process, starting from the point of origin to the point of giving the products to the customers. No, the way they are planning, the way they are implementing the process, and the way they are controlling all the procedures for the effective use of transportation, from the starting, from the point of origin till the point they are giving the product to the customer, is nothing but the logistics. Okay, and the transportation. Transportation means it's nothing but the traveling mode from one point to another point by giving the product from one point to another point by using the different modes of transportations. Okay, and what are the roles we are going to see in transportations? We'll see one topics. Yes, shall we start? Okay, transportation is nothing but the movement of products from one location to another location. Okay, and this is actually the beginning for the supply chain process. Okay, this is actually the beginning for the supply chain process, and transportation actually plays a major role in supply chain, because some products are rarely produced and they are rarely consumed in the same locations. Here, the transportation, it actually plays a significant role in supply chain. Why? Because 6% of GDP has been occurred by the transportations. 6% of GDPs has been occurred by the transportations. Why? Because like this, they have given general information for transportation. The housing, healthcare, and food, it actually brings a good contribution for the GDP because of the transportation. Why? Because most of the people are using the transportation for getting the employment. So this transportation helps in bringing the GDPs like more than 6%. Okay. Now, with the growth of like in e-commerce as well as in the home delivery products, now the transportations are having a more significant in retailing. Yes, even from the book industry, even to the grocery industries like the Amazon, Flipkart, what they are doing, they're delivering the products. They are delivering the products to their home. And that actually because of this transportations. Yes, even from the book industries and even the grocery industries, online, Amazons, they are giving the small package to the customer's home. Okay, instead of having a full trucks to the retail shops, they are selling the small package to the home with the door delivery. Okay, this has given a good transportation that actually results in the more transportation cost will be have more delivered cost of products sold on the online. Okay. And another thing is supply chain success. No, supply chain success is closely linked to the transportations. And the big success, last week we have seen the Walmart example, right? Walmart, how they have achieved their success is like they are having a effective transportations. Okay, why? Because to lower overall cost, they have used a effective transportation. How they have achieved means like to achieve the high product level, product availability at all the reasonable prices. Whenever the customer is asking the product, the Walmart will not say we are not out of stock. Every time they'll be having the product availability at all the prices. So what they'll be doing? No, they'll be having a low level of inventory. Okay, at the stores, they'll be having a low level of inventories. And what they'll be doing, they will be frequently replenishing. Replenishing means to fill the again. Once the products are sold out, they'll be frequently replenishing. For that, what they are needed, the transportations. For that, they need a lot of transportation. Then what they have did for lowering the transportation cost, what they did, they aggregated the products for the different retail stores leaving at the trucks. What means they'll be having a lot of suppliers. In all ways, they'll be having the suppliers and they'll be having a lot of trucks. Okay. Whenever the product they are needed, they'll be getting the products from the suppliers with a lot of trucks. Okay. At the distribution center, Walmart, they'll be using the cross-decking. What is cross-decking? Any idea? What is cross decking, ma? What is cross decking? Yes, Karthik. What is cross docking? Yes, what is cross docking?
Is it cross talking or
cross docking? Cross docking. Yes.
Term also, what is it?
Actually, the products will be no products will be exchanged between the trucks. Why? Because no, each truck will be going to the retail stores as the product from the different suppliers. Walmart, what they'll be doing? No, they'll be having a lot of suppliers. Okay, small retailers as their suppliers, and they'll be having the lot trucks. Okay, whenever the product in the Walmart gets sold out, they'll be doing this cross docking. Cross docking means the trucks will be going to the suppliers, and they'll be getting the products from the suppliers, and they are having that. From this way, they can even lower the transportation cost, as well as they can evenly give the product at a reasonable price. Okay. And likewise, only the Walmart, no, they are having the key for success is actually the supply transportations. Okay. Okay. And what are the factors affecting the transportations? What are the factors affecting the transportations?
Weather conditions.
Weather conditions. Okay. I just want to know what is shipper and what is carrier. Well, who's a shipper and who's a carrier?
Ma'am, receives good by sea and air is a shipper.
Okay, then who's a carrier?
Carrier is a transporter and shipper is the person who is sending the goods.
Yes, exactly. Shipper is nothing but the movement of products. Okay, between two points. He is actually the moving the products between two points. He is a shipper. And carrier means he is actually the transports the products. Sariya, shipper appadinaale vandu, he is actually the person moving the product. And the carrier is actually the mode they are using for moving the product. No, there is a carrier. I'll just give you the example. Dell, no? This Dell company, they want to move the computers to the customers, and they are using UPS system. Okay, they are using the UPS system. Here, who is the shipper and who is the carrier? I'll tell you, Dell, they want to move the computers. They want to move the computers to the customers. Okay, from the factory, they want to move the computers to the customers, Dell. And they are using like UPS transport system they are using. Here, who is the shipper and who is the carrier?
Dell is the shipper.
Dell is the shipper. Very good. Dell is the shipper. Okay. He is moving the product. Okay. And UPS is the carrier. The mode he is using is actually the UPS. He is the carrier. Okay, and based upon this fact, carrier and the shipper, the factors will be affecting the transportation decisions. Okay, carrier persons know they'll be making the investment decisions, like the roadways or even the tracks, trucks or aeroplanes or even the locomotives, what they are going to use. Based on that, they'll be taking the decisions. Okay, and this shipper, no, what he'll be thinking, no, like the inventories, even the transportations and the informations and the facilities, he'll be taking the decisions related to this. Okay, and what this carrier is, no, while he's taking the decisions, what are the factors will be affected is vehicle related cost. Okay, why? Because the vehicle related cost is nothing but the purchase or the lease the vehicle is using to transport the goods. Hello. Yes, can you mute your mic? Sridharan, can you mute your mic? Yes. For taking the career decisions, now what are the factors will be affected is, first one is vehicle related cost. Okay, this cost will occur for the purchase or even the lease you're taking the vehicle, no, for transporting the goods. That will actually affect the decisions. The first one is the for transporting the goods, you will be purchasing the vehicle or even you will be taking the lease the vehicle. Yes. And here, no, this vehicle related cost will be whether you'll be using the vehicle or not, but you have to pay the money. Okay, that comes under the vehicle related cost. And the next one is fixed operating cost. The fixed operating cost means like the cost here, what is that? No, the terminal charges, the airport gate charges, even the labors. If you're using or not, you have to pay the money. Okay, that comes under the fixed cost. Even though here in fixed operating cost, if the drivers are being paid independently, the salaries are being paid, that means the amount also should be added at the fixed cost here. Okay, and the next one is trip related cost. Trip related cost means here the cost for vehicles, how much time you're moving the vehicles for transporting the goods. Okay, and how much time the vehicle is coming to the port or even the port or in the flight, whatever else, to the terminals, how much times the vehicle is moving the goods, and it will also include the price of the labor as well as the fuel. Okay, these three costs now will be affecting the career's decision. Career is nothing but the party who moves or transports the product. Okay, and what are the factors that will affect the career decisions is vehicle related cost, fixed operating cost, and the next one is trip related cost. Yes. Okay, and then next one is shipper. Okay, here now the shipper, what are the factors affecting the shipper decisions will see. Means here the shipper's decision is based upon the means of transport. Okay, the transportation cost. Okay, here known the transportation cost means the total amount for paid for various carriers ka nama pay pan the amount you will be paying, no, that comes under the transportation cost. Okay, it depends upon the prices offered by different carriers. Prices will be different. Okay, the carriers how much he is asking, no, it depends upon them. And this is actually the and this will also extend like the use of inexpensive or a slow or expensive and the fast means of transportation. If you are using an inexpensive or a slow transportation or expensive, whatever, no, it depends on that. The transportation cost will be more. And inventory cost is nothing but here known the cost of holding the inventories. Okay, within the shipper's supply chain network, no, they'll be holding the inventories for like 1 week, 2 days or whatever. That cost will occur, no, that actually comes under the inventory cost. This will be affecting the shipper's decisions. And the next one is facility cost. Okay, facility cost is nothing. Hello, can you hear me? Yes.
Yeah, ma'am, can you?
Yes. Okay, ma. Okay. Yes. Here, facility cost means like this is also within the supply chain network, and the cost which is like the warehouses charges and whatever the facilities that you're going to have it within the transportation, that also comes under the facility cost. Okay. These are the decisions that will be affecting the shipper. And the transportation cost, the inventory cost, and the facility cost. Yes. Okay. Next topic is the mode of transportation. What are the modes of transportations are there? What are the modes of transportations are there?
Land, air, sea.
Land, air, sea, then?
Railroad.
railroad then.
Then.
Okay. Good. And first one is we are going to see truck. Okay. Actually, truck no. Truck will comes under the two types: truck load or less than truck load. Okay, the truck industries. This is actually having two segments. When the first one is truck full load, it will actually tell us TL, and the less than truck load is LTL. Okay, here know this TL operations. They'll be charging a full truck. Okay, and it's actually independent of quantity shopped. Rates will be vary, depends upon the distances. How much the product is moving, no? Based upon that, the rates will be charged. Like less truck load, what will be doing, no? They'll be charged based upon the quantity. Based upon the quantity, how much the products you are loading, no? Based upon that, they'll be charging. And even as well as the distance, how much they are traveling. And this trucking, no? This truck mode of transportation is more expensive. Okay. Then the railways. Okay. Then the railways. Trucking is more expensive than railways. But the biggest advantage is like they'll be giving a door-to-door shipment. And you'll be having a shorter deliver time. Yes. It will be having a shorter deliver time. I'll tell you again. Truck comes under the two categories. Truck load or less than truck load. Truck load means they'll be having a full truck with a full loading. Okay. And here, no, the rates may be vary depend upon the distance only. But in LTL, the charges will be based upon the quantity. The quantity, how much you're loading in the truck and the distance. Okay. This truck is more expensive than railway. But the biggest advantage here is like they'll be giving a door-to-door shipment. And the deliver time and truck calls will be a very less. Okay. Yes. We'll see the what are the advantages. See, what are the advantages, ma? If you're using truck means the advantages, the low cost. For transporting the goods, it will actually have the low cost. And you can have the good accessibility. And you can have a frequent shipments and the small shipments also. And the speed will be good. And same, the disadvantage here is again the costly and even the capacity. You cannot have too much of goods to transfer the products. Okay. And the range is here like the value of the product. The value of the product, if you are having a too much of high value product, you cannot ship by using the trucking. Okay. And the next one is air. What is air? What does it mean, air mode transportation?
By flight, ma.
Sorry, ma.
By flight.
Flight, yes. Airplane. Okay. And like the airlines, no, the main goal is to maximize the daily flying, right? And the maximum goal is to daily flying time. Okay. And the revenue generated by each trip. Okay. This air carrier, no, they'll be offering a very fast and fairly expensive transportations. Yes, even with a small value of items or a time sensitive emergency shipments, we can use this air transportations. Okay, and usually, no, this air carriers, no, they'll be moving the products under 500 pounds. Okay, this 500 pounds might be the high value. A high value product, but it will be a lightweight. Okay, it will be a lightweight or the high tech products. Usually, this air carriers, it will be very fast. It will be very fast. Like emergency time, also, you can have this shipments. And this will also carry the small value products as well as the high value products. This air carriers, no, usually they'll be having, they can carry 500 pounds. Okay, and this 500 pounds like high value of the product, but it will be very lightweight or even the move weight also. Okay, but under the 500 pounds, they can transfer the products. Okay, yeah, the Dell, no, they'll be using many of the components, no, they'll be getting the components from Asia by using this Airways. Okay, with the high technology growth, no, the weight of the freights, what they are doing, no, they have been diminished, like the last two gates, they have diminished the weight for the cargoes. Okay, and the advantages, what are the advantages of using this air transport? And it's actually the premium transportation mode. You can have a speed deliver. Okay. High range of products can also be transported, and even the perishable products. Okay. And this is also used for urgent delivers. This is also used for urgent delivers. But the disadvantages, like the prices. Prices will be more. If you're transporting the products in the flight, the prices will be more. And no direct points will be used. Like in trucks, you can give the door-to-door delivers. To the direct to the retails, you can give the product by using the trucks. But in flights, the direct points will not be there. That is the biggest disadvantage. And even the add-on charges will be there. If you are moving the product on the airways, the charges will be more. Add-on charges will be more. Okay? Yes. And the next one is railways. And what is railways? What is railways?
By train, ma'am.
By train, the products will be moving, right? Yes. Yeah, no, the railways, they'll be having a high fixed cost in terms of actually tracks or the cars or the yards, okay? And here, no. Okay. Here, there'll be a significant drift related to the labor or even the fuel cost that is actually independent of the numbers of cars, like the independent numbers of the compartments you are using, no? That is actually independent. But that this will, no, vary, depends upon the distance traveled and the time taken. Okay. Once the train is started means it's actually very expensive because you have to give the money for the labors as well as the fuel cost. Okay. But even at the idle time also, like some goods will be moving and by night time or even the evening time, they'll be stopping in some stations for 2 hours, 3 hours, whatever. But for that time also, they have to pay the money. Okay, so here now the train cost will be more. And like here now, for the rail transportations, what is the product majorly they'll be transporting is like coal. Coal is the major transportations used by the railways. Okay, and here the advantages like the overall lowest cost per unit. Okay, the cost for what the product you're moving, no, the cost will be low. And you can have a consistent time schedule. The time schedule you can manage. Okay. And most types of goods you can be shifted. Okay. And you can, this from this railway modes, you can move the product in any type of weather. And even the large volume of products can be transported by using the railways. Okay. But the disadvantage is this is not a flexible transportation. Okay. And the damages may happen. Okay. And if you're having a small ship moving products, means this will not be suitable. Okay. And these are the disadvantages of having the railways. Okay, the next one is waterways. Waterways, what is the waterways? Coming to your major, what is waterways?
By ship.
By ship. You can explain, no, how the products are moving by ship. Yes. Yes, you can also explain. By ship. Yes. Okay. Water transport, no, by ship. This is actually used for carrying the very large products at the very lower cost. Okay, at the lower cost, you can use this water transportation. And US and all know, within the US, water transport is actually used as a primary movement for having a large large commodities like bulk shippings. No, they'll in within the United States, they'll be using this water transportation. Okay, and this is the cheapest mode for carrying that loads. But here, no, in water transportation by ships means this is actually the slowest mode of all the types. Comparing to the highways, roadways, shipping is actually, waterways is the slowest mode. Okay, and it may have some delays based upon the ports or even the terminals. Some delays may happen in the shipping. Okay, and even though this makes no water transport difficult to operate in short hull trips. Okay, it will also very difficult in like moving in short hull trips. This is while having this transportation, no, it will be quite difficult. And the advantages is here is you can carry a large volume of products. And even for the longer distance, you can use the water transportation. And the disadvantages is like, this is actually the slower than all the modes. And you can have only the limited access. Okay. Okay. And what are the types of cargo ships you're having? What are the types of cargo ships you're having?
Bulk carriers.
Ah, okay. Containers. What is bulk carriers, ma? What is bulk carrier?
Carrying the goods in the bulk form.
Fully in the bulk form. Like here, no, they'll be transporting the
like rice. Rice, cement, urea.
Coal, grains, ore, whatever.
Yes,
like
this in the bulk forms.
Okay. What is lake freighters? Lakers. For inland water. Here, no, they'll be having same bulk carriers, but through the Great Lakes, they'll be transporting. Am I right? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next one, what is container ships?
Parcel carriers,
ma'am. Parcel carriers, ma'am.
Okay.
It is a different types of cargo will be there. There is not okay. A separate, only certain cargoes.
Okay. Next one. Unloading container ships. What is it? Unloading container ships. They'll be using the cargo
the
cranes,
don't
no?
Have the cranes.
Okay. For unloading all the containers,
they have the
no?
Shore cranes.
Okay. They have to unload all the... Okay, discharging, yes. Unloading the purpose, okay. And the next mode of transportation is pipeline. What is pipeline?
Transporting the fuels.
Transporting like the fuels, okay. Transporting the fuels.
Maybe in inland only. We can transport only in inland. Inland only.
Inland only. Okay. Pipeline. Yes. For transporting the petrols or oils, whatever, they'll be using this pipeline system. Okay. Pipeline system. Here, no. The fixed cost will be incurred for pipelines with the infrastructures, and that will not vary. No. They'll be having some fixed cost for moving the fuels or petrols, whatever. Okay, they'll be having the fixed cost. Even the pipe might be very big or the pipe might be very small. But here, no, the cost will be fixed. Okay. And they'll be, by using this pipeline, they'll be transporting the fuels. Okay. And what are the advantages here is like, they can transfer only the homogeneous materials like the petrols or whatever. Okay. And here the transportation cost will be very low. Comparing to the other modes, the transportation cost will be more, very less. Okay. And here, no, you can transfer only the crude, petroleum or fuels, whatever. But you cannot transport other variety of materials here. And the disadvantages is like leakage in the pipes may happen. Okay, leakage in the pipes may happen. And even the wastage of materials might be happening. And here, no, the maintenance charges more. You have to keep on maintaining this pipeline transportations. The charges will be more. Okay. And the next one is, this is actually pipeline. Okay. Next one is intermodal. What is intermodal? What is intermodal?
Like between the states, between...
No. Actually, not between the states. Like the using of more than one transportation, one mode of transportations. No, that is actually the intermodal transportations. Okay. What I'll be doing, no, my company is in Andhra or whatever, okay, in one state. I'll be manufacturing the product and I'll be moving my product in a trucks. After that, I'll be delivering the product in ship. Okay, from the products will be moving in the ship, and again I'm just using the trucks to give the products to the retailers or even the wholesalers. I'm just using more than one mode of transportations. No, that is actually the intermodal transportations. Okay, here now the containers are easy to transport, like one mode to another mode. Mainly we will be using the containers, right? Containers, it will be easy for moving the products like in one mode to another mode of transportations. Yes. And this intermodal, no? This will bring together the different modes of transportation to create the price or the service offering, and that cannot be matched by the single mode. Okay. The prices will be very high if you are using one mode of transportations. And by using this intermodal, no, you can have a different, you can have the prices will be less. Okay, you can have the services in a good manner, effective way. By using this way, no, you can easily transport the products at the quicker time. Okay, for this purpose, they'll be using the intermodal transportations. Yes, this is the five modes of transportations we have seen. Okay, we'll see just the overview. What are the advantages and disadvantages of using these four modes? By using the roadways, no, you can, the main advantages like door-to-door delivery you can use. And it is quick and convenient. Flexible routes and times. At whatever the time you can transport, you can move the products. And easy to transport all the types of goods by using the roadways. Here are the disadvantages. If you're having the large loads, heavy bulk loads, means it's actually the difficult. And even the urban sites, it's very difficult. And damage of roads. If the damages of roads are there, means it's very difficult by using the road transportation. And the advantages of the railways. It's very efficient in moving the bulk products and the heavy goods. By using railways, you can move the bulk products and the heavy goods. And cheap over long distance. Yeah, it will be cheap. Okay, but the disadvantages, slower than the road, okay, and lack of flexibilities and the routes even. And lot of country is not serviced by, yes, most of the countries, they are not having the railway services, okay. And this is not the door-to-door deliver process. By using the seaways, and by using the seaways means it's actually by, you can use bulk and heavy goods, you can move, same like railways. Okay. Ships, no, this is actually adaptable for the many types of goods, for the many variety of goods, ships is more suitable. And this is also actually the cheaper for longer distance. And the main disadvantage is it's actually slow, not in door-to-door process. And this is not convenient for at a located from port. This is actually, this will not be convenient place for some other ports. Okay. And the highways, this is very fast and closely supervised to losses are minimal. like here, no, in Harveys, no, the losses will not happen like too much. The losses will be like very few. But the disadvantage is high cost, and same here also, this is not a door-to-door process. Okay. Yes. Okay. I'll tell you that next. Okay. Design options for a network. Okay, this transportation networks, you know, that will actually affect the performance of supply chains. Okay, even with the infrastructures, the way the operating the transportation decisions, including the routing your routes you are decided, and even the scheduling times you have decided, no, that will also affect the entire supply chain process. Okay, a well defined transportation, no, that will allows the supply chain to achieve the responses at lower cost. You can achieve the profits, okay, but the responses will be more at, and you can achieve all those things at the lowest transportation cost. Okay, and the first under the design options for transportation network, we are going to see the first type. Okay, direct shipment network. What is direct shipment network? What is actually the direct shipment network? Any idea what is direct shipment network? Hello?
Ma'am, there is no in-between person. Directly, yes. Shippers to buyers.
Yes. Directly shipment network means what here, no, the transportations, they'll be having all the shipments come directly from the suppliers to the retail stores. Okay, no in between hub will be there, no in between hub will be there, or no other like mode of transportations, that will not be there. From the buyers, it will be directly going to the retail shops. From the suppliers, it will be directly moving to the retail shops. That is actually direct shipment network. Okay. And here, no, the main advantage of having this direct shipment, no, you can have the elimination of warehouses charges, and the operations, no, on the operations, operating parts will be very simple, and the coordinations also will be very simple. Okay. And here, no, the shipment, the transportation decisions, no, it's completely a local, and it's completely local, and the decisions what you're making for moving one product, no, that will not influence the other decisions. Okay. And the next thing is the transportation time, no, from the supplier to the users, it will be very short, because the shipment is like a completely direct. Yes, that the from the supplier, it's moving only to the users, right? So the time will be, transportation time will be more. These are the advantages of having the direct shipment network. Okay. Okay. Direct shipping with milk runs. What is direct shipping with milk runs? What is actually direct shipping with milk runs, ma? Any idea? Okay. Milk run means what they'll be doing. No, milk run means they'll be having the truck. Okay. They'll be delivering the product from the single supplier to the multiple retailers. Like one supplier, I'm the supplier, I'm just giving my products to Karthik, Satyanarayanan, and some other students are there, no, Sridhar. You are the retail stores you are having. I'm the single supplier. I'm just having my truck, and I'll be giving my goods to all these people. No, this is actually the milk run. Okay. or what and another vice versa is like more retailers will be there, sorry, more suppliers will be there, more suppliers will be giving the product to the single retailer. That is actually direct shipping with milk runs. Milk run is nothing but the truck, either they deliver the product from single supplier to multiple retailers or from multiple suppliers to single retailer. That is actually the direct shipping with milk runs. Okay, the supplier might be one, but he'll be giving the product to 4 to 5 customers. Okay, or vice versa, like 4 to 5 suppliers will be there. They'll be giving their product to a single customer. No, that is actually direct shipping with milk runs. Okay. Yes.
Yeah, ma'am, understand.
Okay. Okay. Next one is shipping via DC. What is DC? Distribution center. What is shipping via DC? Any idea? Yes. What is ship DC? Distribution center.
Okay. Maybe everybody giving to a common point. From that common point, it is getting segregated.
Yes, exactly. The suppliers know they will not send the shipments directly to the retail stores. Okay. They will not give the product directly to the retail stores. And this retail chain also divides the stores by like geographic locations. There'll be one retail stores will be in a completely in urban area, and one will be completely in city, one will be completely in rural areas. Like they'll be splitting up the retail stores. Okay, and for that reason, they'll be having this distribution center. Suppliers, what they'll be doing? No, they'll be sending the shipments to the DCs. Okay, to the distribution centers, and this distribution centers, no, they further forward all those products to the retail shops. Okay, this DC, no, it's actually acting as an extra layer between the suppliers and the retailers. And they will also play a different roles, two different roles. One is to store the inventories. Okay. And another one is to transfer the locations. This DC, they are working as an inventory place, like the warehouses or hub, whatever. And another thing, they are transferring the products to the different locations. Okay, this is the like milk runs means directly they are moving the products. And here, no, with the DC, distribution center, suppliers will be giving the product, all the products will be moving to the distribution center. And from the distribution center, the products will be moving to the retail shops. Okay. Yes. We'll see the pros and cons, like the advantages and the disadvantages. Okay, direct shipping means like no intermediate warehouses will be there. That is the advantage. Okay, that is the biggest advantage. And here, no, same. See, it's actually very simple to coordinate. But the disadvantages is like you have to have lot of inventories. You have to have lot of inventories. And the receiving expenses will also be more. In direct shipping means from supplier to the customers. Okay, but here direct shipping with milk runs means transportation cost will be lower and the inventories you can have will be very less. Okay, but here the disadvantages, coordinations, the messages, the informations will be more complexity. The decisions you have to take, no, that will be more complex. Okay, and via DC with inventory storage. With DC with inventory storage means low inbound transportations will be low. Okay, but the disadvantages, you will be having the inventory cost high and handling cost will be more at the distribution center. Okay, and here distribution center with cross docking means again here the inventory requirements will be very low. And the transportation cost will also be low. But here saying the decisions you have to take, no, that will be more. The coordination will be very complex. Okay. DC using milk runs. Milk runs means same concept. Lower outbound transportation cost will be low. Outbound transportation cost will be more, less. Okay. But here, same disadvantage, my coordination will be very complex. Okay, next one, we'll see about the tailored network. After that, we can have the advantages and disadvantages. Okay. Okay. Any idea about Taylor network? Any idea about Taylor network? Yes. Okay.
No, ma'am.
No idea. Okay. Taylor network, no. Here, what they'll be doing, the transportations, they'll be using all the combinations like cross docking, milk runs, truck loader, less truck load carriers, and even the package carriers. They'll be using the combination of all the networks, no? That comes under the Taylor network. The Taylor network, why they are using all this type of transportations, no? Like, whatever the situations, wherever the situation is difficult, no, in that situations they have to use the cross decks. If the situations are more risk, they can use the milk runs or even the truck loads. Based upon all those things, no, based upon the situations, they'll be using the appropriate options. That comes under the Taylor network. Okay. Even like high volume of products to the high volume of retail outlets that may be shipped directly. Okay. And even the low volume of products from the DC, they can move the products to the retails. Whatever that depends upon the situations, they'll be using like cross docking or a milk runs or a truck load. Even the package carriers they are using, no, that comes under the tailored networks. Okay. Yes. Okay. Have you all heard about Dabbawala? Have you all heard about Dabbawala?
In Mumbai, they mostly.
In Mumbai, they'll be using mostly. What is actually Dabbawala?
They are transporting a food, ma'am. Means home food to the office. Persons working at the office, they are transferring the food from the home. That's all, ma'am.
Yes, that is actually the Dabbawala. Dabbawala's main concept is like they'll be giving the foods from the people to the office who are working, no? They'll be giving the foods to the office employees. The transferring of foods from home to the office is like Dabbawala's. Okay, and this, no, this was started in 1880. Okay. And how much kilometers they are covering is like 60 kilometers they are covering. And even the employee strength is like 5,000. And how much tiffin boxes they are having, no? Like 2 lakh tiffin boxes they'll be having. Which means like per day they'll be having a transactions of 4 lakhs tiffin boxes. Like morning they'll be having with full loaded tiffin box. From the home, they'll be carrying and they'll be giving to the each and industry peoples, they are, wherever they are working, no, they'll be moving. Like 200 tiffin box, they are moving. After they are having their lunch, they'll be again returning the tiffin box, and this tiffin box will be made the home, no, like same, 2 lakhs, like for every day, 4 lakh transactions will be taken. And in how much time, no, within 3 hours, they'll be moving this product. They'll be moving this Dabbawalas. Okay. And here, no, how the approach will be there, like this Dabbawalas, how they'll their approach is like, they will not have alcohols during business times. They will not have alcohols. Okay. And during the business hours, they'll be having that white cap and they'll be carrying the ID cards. Okay. Even the women's are working. And marketing message, what they'll be giving, no? The latest strategy, what they are using is like Dabba. Okay. What they'll be doing, no? Every day, whatever, the service will not be interrupted. Okay. Even in the extreme weather, like high rainfalls or even the more summers or whatever, but the service will not be get interrupted. Okay, what they'll be doing, you know, this local dabba walas, they'll be receiving and sending the tiffin boxes directly from the customers. Okay, directly from the customers. Why? Because the customers, they'll be personally knowing these people, so that there will not be lack of trust. They will not be having any questions like they'll why? Because they are personally knows each other persons. Okay, and this no, they were all to the local areas. They'll be catered and they will allow them to access at any destinations with easily. Okay, why? They know personally and they can easily move the product. They can go and get the products at any decisions. Okay, and occasionally what these peoples will be doing, no, they'll be communicating between the home and by work by putting the message inside the boxes. Okay, this was happened before the telecommunication. Before telecommunications, what they'll be doing, they inside the different boxes, they'll be putting the message and they'll be giving. By giving that message, they'll be moving. Okay. And this dabba, by this dabba walas, no, the first groups, no, like total earnings for 20 people will be like around 1,25,000. Okay, and the maintenance charges, no, maintenance charges they'll be taking for 35,000. And the basket passes for a tiffin luggage, whatever, no, for one person they'll be charging 180 rupees. And for the maintenance of cycles, like 300 rupees, like two cycles per month they can maintain. Okay, and even the wooden boxes they are using, no, 100 rupees per month. Okay, in case the police robbery or tiffin box, like 500 rupees, like per year they'll be charging. And organizational charges, like 15 rupees per head they'll be charging. Okay, and by this way their earnings is like 1,25,000. This dabba wala, like we just what we will be knowing, like it's actually the small process. People are taking that tiffin box and they are moving, but it's actually the very biggest logistics process they have used. Like they'll be working like 24 hours a day, 7 days in a week, and even the 52 weeks a year. Okay, the way they are without the technologies, they are using this dabba wala techniques, and they have grown up in a very big process in Mumbai. Okay, what they'll be doing now, by like 10 o'clock, 10:34 to 11:20, this period what they'll be taking now, they'll be loading all the woods in the cycles. Okay, with the tiffin boxes, like they'll be having all those in a good compartments, like train based compartments they'll be having. Okay, generally what they'll be choosing, no, they'll be choosing the last compartment for filling this tiffin boxes. By 11:20 to 11:30, what they'll be doing, no, they'll be unloading all the goods. Okay, wherever the companies they are getting, no, they'll be giving all the tiffin boxes to them. And again that again they what they'll be doing, no, they'll be doing the rearrangement of tiffin boxes as per the destinations are they, no, they'll be rearranging the tiffin boxes. Okay, in particular areas, no, with high density of customers are there, means they'll be having a special crate, like special two more, three more shelves they'll be having. Okay, and shelves they are telling, no, I'm just telling, no, it will be having like 150 different boxes, and this will actually like the 2 to 3 dabba walas will be driving the cycles. Again, by 1:15 to 2 p.m., what they'll be doing, no? Again, they start be collecting all the tiffin boxes from the employees, from the offices, no? Like almost 1 hour, they'll be doing this. After 2 to 2:30, this people, no? They'll be start grouping all the dabba wala peoples, no? They'll be start grouping and they'll be start segregating the tiffin boxes based upon their locations, okay? By 2:48 to 3:30, the return journey by train, like finally they meets up with the entire day routines, no, they'll be collecting all the tiffin boxes and they'll be giving. Okay, Usually, this is actually more pleasant of journey compared to the earlier part of the day. The dabba wallas know they'll be having like jokes or singing, whatever they'll be doing, and they'll be returning. This 3:30 to 4:30 is actually the final dispatch takes place. The group meets at the origin stage and finally sort out the different works as per the origin area. Okay, like within this three hours, how the products are moving from the customers to the companies, to from the suppliers to the customers, how they are moving, in what ways they are moving, based like if demands are more, means if the more demands are there, they are using like two to three craft wooden crafts are there, like more different box you can have, and there what they'll be using, like 2 to 3 dabba wallas will be going there. Same concept what we have seen, like if the demand is more, means we have to send two or three trucks should be transported, right? Same ways the dabba wallas, with all the technologies, like these people, so they'll be joining and they'll be segregating, like for this areas, 10 tiffin boxes are needed. So you can have this tiffin boxes. All these things, they'll be moving, and after 1 hour, they'll be again collecting all the tiffin boxes. All the tiffin boxes, again, they'll be just coming to one places. Okay, these people, what they'll be doing, based upon their locations, again, this empty tiffin boxes will be segregated and they'll be moving with their own destinations. Okay, this is actually the concept of dabba wala. Yes? Yes?
Yes, ma'am, understand.
Okay, ma'am. I'll just give you 5 minutes break. By 10:40, ten ten, we can meet, ma. Yes, we'll start. Trade-off in transportation decision. Has everyone came? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Trade-off in transportation decision. What is actually trade-off? Any idea of trade-off? Okay, compromising in one situation is nothing but the trade-off. And while taking the transportation decisions, what are the trade-off? What are the compromising solutions you are going to take? Okay. All the transportation decisions, no, in supply chain must be made taking in the account like the inventory cost, facility, and even the processing cost. Okay. Like I'll just tell you the example. In Dell, no, they'll be using the package carriers for delivering all the PCs to the customers to increasing the transportation cost. Okay. But this Dell, no, they allows to centralize the facilities. Okay. But they are allowing to centralize this facilities. If the Dell want to reduce the transportation cost, means company either they have to sacrifice the responses to the customers, or they have to increase the number of facilities. Okay, that is actually the trade-off. Trade-off is nothing but either they have to sacrifice the one thing, like they have to compromise. If they this Dell means they want to reduce the transportation cost, means the customers, no, they have to sacrifice the customers. Obviously, right? I just want to reduce all the transportation costs, so I will not be moving my product to the distance place. If he is giving in that explanation, means the next thing, he has to sacrifice the customers. Or else he has to increase the facilities, like in the distance place, he has to keep lot of what we can tell, like warehouses or even some other plant, like second plant, like a third plant, he have to keep more facilities there. Okay, if one thing are to be decided, means the another thing has to be sacrificed. Okay, here the cost, no, for operating is generally hard to quantify. Okay, the manager regarding taking the decisions, no, they have to consider the following trade-offs: transportation and the inventory cost, as well as the transportation cost with the customer responsiveness. Okay, what are the decisions he has to take? Transportation between the inventory cost, as well as the transportation cost and the customer responsiveness. First one, we are going to see the transportation and the inventory cost. here how the choice of transportation should be there. Okay, before like selecting the transportation, no, it should be both match the planning as well as the operational decisions in the supply chain. Okay, the if for selecting the transportation mode, it should match both the planning as well as the operational decisions. Okay, and this decisions, no, that should carry which companies contracts with the planning decisions, the whether the choice of transportation mode, no, for particular shipment is operational decisions. Okay, for the okay, for both the decisions, no, the shipper must balance transportation as well as the inventory cost. Here the mode of transportations they are using, no, that will actually result in the low transportation cost, and that, no, that necessarily will not reduce the total cost of the supply chain. Okay, first one is choice of transportation mode, and the next one is inventory aggregation. What is actually the inventory aggregation? What is actually inventory aggregation, ma? Aggregation is nothing but the segregations. Okay, what all the industries know, they'll be doing, no, they'll be reducing the safety inventory. Okay, for requiring like physical aggregating of the, all the inventories in one locations. Most of the e-businesses, like they'll be having this advantages. Okay, by having facilities in many locations. Best example is Amazon. Okay, they are focusing on decreasing its facilities and the inventory cost by holding inventories in few warehouses. Okay, they'll be having the inventories in few warehouses. Okay, but this booksellers know what they'll be having. They'll be holding the inventories in lot of retail shops. If I'm just having, if I'm just booking the products in Amazon's means, like in they'll be having facilities in lot of locations. My if I'm just booking one sari, but the product will be coming from Gujarat, there they'll be having the facilities. So they'll be having the plant and they'll be getting the product. Okay, they'll not be holding the more inventories. Okay, but like the booksellers, what they'll be doing, no, they'll be holding the inventories in all the retail shops. This is the differences. Okay, why if the inventories are aggregated, means the transportation cost will also get increased. Okay. Okay, next one is between the trade-off between the transportation cost and the customer responsiveness. Here, no, the transportation cost is actually closely relative to the responsivenesses of the customers. Okay, if the industry is having high responses, means, and is actually shipping all the orders within the day. Okay, within the day, it will have a small outbound shipments or whatever, but it will result in the high transportation cost. Okay, if the responsiveness or decreases and the aggregating orders, it will taking actually longer time. Okay, and it will be exploiting the economics of scale. And here, what will happen? No, transportation cost will be lower because of the larger shipments. Okay, this is the transportation and the responsiveness trade-off. Okay, and the next one is choice of transportation modes and how we can select the transportations. Depending upon the goods, then anything else?
Depending upon our locations. Budget, ma'am.
Okay, depending upon the budgets. Okay, then what else? Depending upon the goods and depending upon the budgets, even the depending upon the locations, the choice of transportation modes are being selected. Okay, Okay. What is the role of IT in transportations? What are the roles of IT in transportations?
Tracking the cargoes.
Okay, then. By using IT softwares, like IT systems, information technology, you can easily track the products, right? And you can easily track the products. Am I right? Where the products are moving and where the faults is happening. If the products are being delayed, if the products moving is are being delayed, means you can easily track by using the GPSs. Yes. And what are the risks are there in transportation? What are the risks?
Damages during travel.
Damages during the travel. Then anything else?
Theft, ma'am.
Theft. Okay, then. If the products are being delayed, then if they are using alternative routes, yes, even the risk of moving with the hazardous materials. These are the risks you are facing, right? While moving the products using transportations, okay? Yes. Shall we move to the next unit? Okay. And the next unit, what you are going to see is facilities in the supply chain. What are the facilities that are being used in the supply chain? Like previous week we have seen what is supply chain, and here no, like each and every link, what are the things we are going to see, that is actually the unit 11, unit 12 and unit 13, 14. Okay. Facility decisions. What is facility decisions, ma'am? What are the facility decisions that will be used in supply chain? Yes, any idea? Yes. Any idea, ma'am? What is facilities?
Facilities, ma'am?
Yes. What is facilities?
No, ma'am, no idea.
Yes, no idea. Seriously? What is actually facilities?
Comforts,
yes. Here, what we are going to see, no? Here in location, supply chain means, facility decisions means the location of manufacturing companies. Manufacturing, okay. And even the storage of the goods. And or even the transportation related facilities. Okay, and each and everything, what are the roles of each facilities, no? That we are going to see, the facility decisions and the network designs and supply chain. What is the location of the manufacturing company? Where you're going to store the products and in what facilities those products will be stored. And even while moving the product, no? While moving the product from one place to another in the transportations and what are the facilities that is related to their products. Each and everything we are going to see. Okay. Here, the next one is roles of facility decisions in the supply chain. Okay. Here, no? What role should each facility play? Okay. What are the process at each facilities they are playing? Okay. Where the facilities should be located and how much capacity should be allocated for each and every facilities. Okay. And what markets should each facility survive? And which supply sources should each feed each facilities? These are the questions that will be rising. Okay. If you are talking about the facility decisions, means these are the questions that will be arising. Okay. Okay. Facility locations means here, no, what will know? Here, facility locations, that is actually the long-term impact. long-term impact on supply chain performance. Okay, long-term impact on supply, it is actually very expensive. Okay, facility locations here means I'll be just today, I'm just making a warehouses. For building a warehouses, it's not a simple process. Okay, like this week, I'm just making the warehouse, building a warehouses, and next year, I'm just demolishing. Means it's great negative impact for my company, right? And that also comes under the facility locations. Facility location decisions, like it's a long-term impact for the supply chain, okay? And it's also and very expensive to even shut down the facility, or you're moving that warehouses to another locations. Okay, for that, what the companies will be doing, no? They'll be live with their locations. They'll be live in their locations for a long time. In many cases, even with like 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, 30 years, they'll be having, if they have built one facility, means one building, means they will not move that. Okay. And even like a good location decisions, no, that will make the supply chain with a good responsive. And that will also keep the cost in a very low manner. Okay. That is actually the supply chain facility location decisions. Supply chain facility location decisions is here like a long-term impact, long-term investments. Once you have been invested here, means you should not change. Why? Because it will give a big losses to a companies. Okay. Like what we can tell, no? Like if you are poorly located the facilities, okay? That is actually very difficult to make a supply chain, means again, that will get a very drastic losses in the company. Okay. Example is here is like Amazon, no? It is very difficult to be very responsive and cost effective in booking throughout the US. Okay, with the single warehouses. Okay, what Amazon know, first it was very difficult to respond to all the customers. Okay, and even with the cost effective, it's very difficult to give the products to the people with the single warehouses. Okay, then what they have did, with all those, you know, they have added a lot of warehouses in other parts of the country. First, Amazon was started in one country, no? There, they are having only one hub. With that, they have to move the product. Like some products, if they're from different countries, they are giving the order, means what will happen? Then again, the problems will occur. It will take too much of time. Everything will be happening. For that reasons, what they have did, no? This Amazon, they have started making a lot of warehouses in all other countries. Okay. If from India, they are ordering... If from Chennai, I'm just ordering one product, means like nearby hub, they'll be moving the product so that I can get the product within the short span of time, and even the cost will be very low, right? For transporting the product for them, the cost will be low. And for us also, the product will be getting a reasonable prices. Okay. And that comes under the facility locations. Okay. And the next one. Next one is capacity allocations. What is capacity allocations? What is capacity allocations, ma?
Depending on the size, ma.
Yes, capacity allocation is like decisions that will also impact your supply chain performance. Okay. Like you can this you can alter more easily than locations. Okay. Capacity decisions tend to stay in the place for several years. But if you're allocating too much of capacities in the same locations, means like it will lead to the poor utilization. And that will also tend to the higher cost. Okay. Allocating too less, if you're having too much, very little capacities, means responses will be poor if the demands are not satisfied. Okay, if you're having too much of facilities, means again that utilizations will be get more poor, very poor, and that will result in the higher cost. Just in simple example, like what will know if you're running a company, if you're running a company, and in a company, it's like a very 400 square feet of a room. Okay, there what you're doing, no, you're just having like the seats for 200 employees. Will that be efficient for the employees to work in that company? Yes. Will that be very efficient to work in the company? I'm just asking you people.
No, yes. No, ma'am, won't be enough. No, we cannot that accommodate. Will not,
yes, you cannot accommodate. You will be get sophisticated, and you cannot. It's very difficult to move from one place to another. You will not be free, and it's very difficult, right? And same, another in contrast, same that 400 square feet of infrastructure, you're just having like two employees. Is that also very useful? Is that useful?
Then yes, it turns expensive.
Yes, that will also in turn have the too much of expensive. Same company, I'm just making the paper. Manufacturing paper. For that, no, I'm just having like 50 machines. 50 machines means the allocation, capacity allocations here. Like with the 50 machines, what I'm going to do? Okay, the utilizations will be very low, and even the cost for having this 50 machines is too much. Okay, if I'm just having only two machines in that paper manufacturing company, means again the responsiveness will be get delayed. Why? Because the demand will be more. I'm just having only two machines, means again it will cost the losses, right? Based upon the capacity, you have to allocate the machines or whatever the resources. Based on the capacity, you have to allocate. That is the network decisions they have to take. Okay, and the next one is allocation of supply sources. What is allocation of supply sources? Any idea? Allocation of supply sources and the markets. Okay, I'll tell you. Here, the next one is allocation of supply sources and the markets. This is also an impact for the supply chain performance. Why? Because no, it will completely affect the total production. Okay, total production of the company, as well as the inventories of the company and the transportations. Okay. Okay, I'll tell you, and again, same with an Amazon example. Amazon, no, now it has been grown with the customer base. Okay, the company, they have built a new warehouses, and they have changed the market supply course also. And even the allocation, market allocations and the supply change can be changed if the facilities are flexible to serve with different markets, right? I can change my warehouses wherever, but they know the market facilities should be flexible, right? The supply of resources should be flexible. Then only I can allocate the different warehouses. I've just started my business. I'm just having the customers from all over the world. Okay, I'm having all over the world. So I'm just start making the warehouses, or I'm just having some more plants in all the countries. But that should not be possible. That is not actually enough. The resources you have to get. You have to get the supply of resources. And even know the market facilities should be there. If this is not there, means what will happen? Again, the network get destroyed. Am I right? The decisions will be get destroyed. Without having the proper supply of raw materials, without having the proper facilities of marketing, how you can run the businesses there in that country? That will also affect the decisions. Okay? Yes?
Yeah.
Okay, and the next one is factors affecting the network design decisions. What are the factors that is affecting the network designs? And the first one is strategy factors. Any idea about strategy factors? Yes. Any idea? Any idea, ma? Okay. Strategy factors. Yeah, no. Convenience store chains, no. Their main aim to provide easy access to the customers. Okay. As the strategy they are using. Okay, easy access. Like if I'm just going to the next shop means I can easily buy the product means I can again, no, I'll be moving to the same shop. So this is the strategy of the company, right? Again, next example here is like the strategy, no. this is actually the main significant impact for the company supply chain. Here also this strategic factors. Why? Because now firms know they'll be focusing on the cost. This will actually find the lowest cost of locations for manufacturing facilities, even like their means of locating very far markets from they serve. Okay. That is also a negative impact. If I'm just having my product in a very long distances means like my customers will not coming there. And again, the strategic factors, what we have seen like last week, like Walmart, what they have did, like within their company, within one shop, they'll be having 20,000 of variety products. So my easy accessible in if I'm just going to that shop means I can buy even the groceries, I can buy even the TV, fridge, everything. That is the strategy they are using. If this strategy was missed, means what will happen? That will be affecting the network designs. That will be even affecting your supply chains. Okay. And what is technology? What is technology? What are the technology factors? Here, okay. If the production technology, no, they are having a significant economics of scale. Okay, with the few locations, they'll be having a more effective performances. Okay, like an example, like in case of manufacturing a computer chips. Okay, we know the factories require very large investment for making the computer chips. It's actually the factory requires a very large investment. As a result, what they'll be doing now, most company build few chips production facilities, and each one they will build as a very large capacity. Like few chips will be produced in the production facilities. They know from there they'll be building large chips. Okay, in this contrast, no, the facilities have lower fixed costs. And local facilities will be preferred because this will help the lower transportation cost. Okay, like here, for making the computer chips, no, here the investment will be more. So what I'll be doing, I'll be having like plants will be very less. Okay, like two manufacturing companies or three manufacturing companies only I'll be having. From that, I'll be making more chips. Okay. But in contrast, like if you're having a Coca-Cola bottle companies or whatever, for making this bottle, no, here the fixed cost will not be very high. For reducing the transportation cost, no, what they'll be doing, no, this Coca-Cola company, no, they have created this manufacturing company in all over the world. For serving all these local markets, no, they have built their manufacturing company in all the world. Okay, this is actually the flexibility of production technology. Okay, and the next one is macroeconomic. What is macroeconomic? Macroeconomic factors means which will affect here is like taxes, tariffs, even the exchange rates that will affecting like the internal or the individual firms, no, that comes under the macroeconomic factors. And next one is what is political? What are the political factors?
What is happening in India?
Sorry, ma. What is that, ma?
What is happening in India?
Okay. Political factors is here, like companies know what they'll be preferring for having their facilities, like the companies or in the warehouses, what they'll be doing, know where they'll be preferring. Like some companies, they'll be having a stable politics. Okay, they'll be having a stable rules for having their businesses, where these companies will be preferring to have their facilities. Okay, companies with like independent and the clear legal systems they are following means they'll be free to have their businesses. Okay, if like some companies here, like they'll be doing some lot of politics, this company, some governments will not be allowing to run some companies, and they'll be, if the companies are not giving good bribes or whatever, no, the even they'll help, they'll be have even possible of shadowing the companies. This will happen. This will also affect your decisions. Okay. And the next one is infrastructure. What is infrastructure? Yes. If you are having a good infrastructure means for locating a good facility means that will give a good income. If you are having the poor infrastructure means it will actually adds the cost for doing your businesses. Okay. Like global companies know, they have located their factories in China. Okay. Even though these locations know, they do not have lowest labor cost or land cost, because the better infrastructures are these locations. Okay. Some global companies, they'll be having their factories near China. Why? Because this location, they don't have the lower labor cost. The land cost will also be more, but the infrastructures will be best in that locations. That's why they'll be having their companies near China. Okay. And the key infrastructure elements, no, that will be considered as a good network design for having the sites. Okay. And the next one is competitive factors. What is competitive factors? Okay, here how the decisions will be made, no, whether to locate their facilities close to the competitors or far from them. Okay, how the firms know completely competing with the competitors, whether from the external factors like how they are getting the raw materials, even the labor availability, even the locations will also influence the decisions. Okay, they'll be here the how they'll be deciding, no, from my competitors, I'll be having my company next to my competitors. That decisions will also influence. Again, even like the raw materials, where they are getting, same my competitors, where they are getting, that will also influence my decisions. Okay. Even the labors, how much labors we are having, the labors will also influence the decisions. And then the last one is logistics and facility cost. What is logistics and facility cost? Any idea? Logistics and facility cost. Okay. Logistics and facility cost means here, no, within the supply chain, the number of facilities how they are having and the locations and the if the capacity allocation is changed. For that, what the company has to consider, no, the inventories, the transportation, facility cost when designing the supply chain networks. Okay. Yes. Okay. Next topic is yes, ma.
I'm not getting your voice.
Okay, and the next one is framework for network design. Framework for network designs. What are the frameworks we are having? We are going to see. Like under this, no, we are having four phases. And the first one is supply chain strategy, and the second one is regional facility, and the third one is desirable sites, and the fourth one is location choices. same concepts, again we are going to reply, again we are going to see. Okay. In the, here now in the phase one, it is actually starts with the supply chain strategy. Okay. Here now what they'll be having, they need to have the set of customers. Okay, that has to be satisfied. For that, what the managers will be doing, no? He'll be forecasting the global competitions. What are the products are moving? Whether the competitors in each market is a local or the global players. Okay, he'll be forecasting. He has to decide. Then again, what this manager, no? He has to identify, no? Available of capitals. If I'm just going to start with this means, it will give the growth into my company or not with the existing facilities or by building a new facilities or with having the partnership, whether my company will be going or not, will be having a growth or not, they'll be deciding. Okay, based on all the strategies, no, and all the analysis of the competitors. Okay. Or even the economics of scale, even the constraints, whatever the limitations we are having, the manager must decide the strategy firm for the companies based upon the competitors, based upon the guessings, all the forecasting thinkings, everything, no, based upon that, he has to determine the strategy. That is the phase one process. And the phase two is like define the regional facilities. And here, no, what is the objective of having the regional facility configuration? The facilities will be located and the potential roles will be there, and even the approximate capacities, they have to identify where the facility should be located and what are the roles they have to have, and is that capacity will be approximate. All those things comes under the regional facility comprehensive. Okay, ma'am. What they'll be doing, no? They'll be start forecasting by the demands of the country. Okay. And this forecasting, no, will also include the size of the demand. Okay. And it will also just guess whether the customer requirements are homogeneous or various across different countries. Like they are preferring one product or they are preferring various products, depends upon the different countries. Okay, if they want to start doing the businesses with homogeneous requirements, means it should have a large facilities. Okay, and that is also depends upon the countries. Countries like they are having the smaller or the local facilities are more, depends upon that they'll be deciding. And then here, no, the next step for manager is to identify the economics of scale plays a significant role in reducing the cost. Okay, for having with the available production technologies, whether this economics of scale will give a good amount. Okay, if this economic scales are significant, means it's better to have a few facilities serving many customers. Like limited set of warehouses will be better for serving more markets. But if the economies of scales are more not significant, means it is better to have each market in its own facilities. Okay, again, same example, like Coca-Cola bottle plants, no, it's in every market it serves, because the manufacturing technology here, no, that will not have more large economies of scale. Okay, the investment will not be much more. But if you're having chip manufacturings, okay, they should have a very small plants. Okay, why? Because the investments are more. Next, what the manager has to identify, no, the demand risk. And he has to identify the political risk and the exchange risk. Okay. Again, in this process, the managers also has to identify the competitors in each region and whether the facilities need to be located close or far to the far from the competitors. Same, whatever we have seen before, no, that all comes under the regional facility configuration. Okay, and the third one is the desirable sites. Okay. Okay. Here the desirable sites. No, the objective is like E. What their objective is like. Whether the sites you are decided, no, that should be within each religion, or the facilities are to be located. Okay. Then the set of desirable sites you are choosing, no, that should be larger than the desirable number of sites to be set up for the precise selections. Okay, like choosing the locations, no, for choosing the locations, that is actually the next phases. That should the desirable site should be more than the location choices. Okay, and this site, no, should be selected based upon the infrastructure availability to support all the production methodology. Okay, like hard infrastructure requirements means the suppliers should be there, the transportation services, and even the warehousing infrastructure should be there. Based upon this, the site should be selected. Like saying the soft infrastructure requirements means like employee with a very skilled, okay, and even the workforce turnover, and even the community related to the business and the industries, that should be there. Based upon this, the site should be selected. And the next one is choose locations. Okay, choose locations. What is actually the choose locations? Okay, here no, the network is designed for maximizing the total profits by taking into the account what you'll be doing, no, the expected margin, even the demand for each and every market you're having, no, with the various logistics and the facility costs, that will actually decides how you have to choose the locations. Okay, based upon the various logistics and the facility cost. Okay, based upon all those things and in demanded each market and whatever the returns you are expecting, based upon that my locations will be there. This is actually the framework for network design decisions. Okay. Yes. Yes. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Making network design decisions in practice. How you are going to have the decisions in practice, we are going to see. Okay. And the first one is you should not underestimate the lifespan of the facilities. You should not underestimate. Why? Because means like facilities, no, it have a long last timing. Okay. And it will actually give the performance, no, the impact of performance, firm's performance is completely based on the facilities. So it's very important to have a long-term facility decisions. Okay. And here, no, the manager must not only consider the future demand and the cost, but he has to consider the scenarios where the technologies are keep changing. Okay, he has to consider. So you should not underestimate the lifespan of the facilities. And the next one is do not gloss over the cultural impactions. What is that? Do not cross over the cultural implications. What is that? Any idea? Yes. Okay. Like here, no, cultural implications, like some companies, they'll be following some set of rules. Okay. Why? Because that is actually applicable to their countries. That has to be followed. Like in some countries, they'll not be allowing some sort of goods. There you should not make, you are going there and you are building some companies there and you are following your own rules, means that is not, it is actually completely affect the decisions. It will completely affect, like the countries will not having their own country will not allow their different cultures in their countries. Okay, that is actually, you should not cross the cultural implications. Okay, and the next one is do not ignore the quality of life issues. Here, the quality of life at selected facilities, no, that will impact the performance. Why? Because no, it influences the workforce available. Okay, in many instances, like a firm, no, better off selecting the higher cost location if it is giving a better quality. You have to, if you want to give the good quality of product, means you have to prefer the high cost of making the locations. Okay. If you're giving the quality, if you want to give the product with a less quantity, means with a less quality, means what will happen? That will affect your, obviously, your businesses. If this is the situation, you have to give the product in a good quality, means if you have to make the you have to make the arrangements in a higher cost. Okay, if you are failing on that, means obviously the entire consequences will be get wasted. Okay, and the next one is focuses on tariffs and tax incentives when locating facilities. Managers know when making the facility decisions, he should be careful in considering the taxes and the tariffs. Okay, when you are having the international locations, means how often the tax incentives will affect the choices of locations, and often overcoming all the cost factors combined. Okay, I just tell you, in Ireland, no, they have developed a high-tech industry by using a low tax rates. Okay, to entire companies locate their European facilities there. Even within the nations, no, local government, they offer generous packages with no taxes. Okay, then the firm decides to locate the facilities within the jurisdiction. This is actually the based upon the taxes and the tariffs, the managers asked to think of the facility locations. Okay, yes. Again, I'll give you 5 minutes of break. Next, I'll continue. Yes?
Yeah, ma'am. Sure. Thank you.
Okay. Okay. We'll start with role of information technology in supply chain management. Okay. And here, no. Information we are going to use in supply chain, no, that will also decide the performance. That will also decide. Why? Because no, it provides the supply chain managers to make the decisions. Okay, based upon this informations only, the supply chain performance will be decided. And the supply chain managers, you know, they can make the decisions. Without the information, the manager will not know what customer is wanting. Okay, how much inventories is there in the stock, and when more products should be produced or shipped. Okay, without information, he does not know what the customer is demanding. Okay, how much inventories are there in the stocks, and how many products are to be produced or shipped, whatever the informations. Without giving the informations, this you cannot make the decisions. Okay, so what we are telling, no, information makes the supply chain, it's actually visible to the manager. Okay, by giving this visibility, no, the manager can make the decision to improve the performance. Okay, for giving the performance. And same scenario, without this information, without having this information, it is impossible to make the supply chain to deliver the products effectively to the customers. Okay. And for this, no, what their managers has to do, managers must understand how information is gathered. Okay. Managers should understand how the information is gathered and how it is analyzed, because it's actually the crucial part of being success in supply chain. Okay. And this information, no, this comes as an information technology. And that is actually, that will be there in hardware or software that is used by the supply chain to gather and analyzing this information. Okay. And here comes the chapter, IT, information technology in supply chain management. This is actually the eye and ears for the management in supply chain, for the capturing all the information and all the and delivering all the information, you know, necessary for making the good decisions. Okay, just an example in IT system. Okay, a personal computer manufacturer, no, may tells the manager how many Pentium chips are in stock for making the new PCs. He'll be telling like personal in a IT system, it will be telling like for making the personal computer and how many Pentium chips are in stocks, it will be telling. Okay. This IT is also used to analyze the information and it will also recommend what the action to be handled. In this way, no, the manager at the PC manufacturing company, no, it will be taking the number of chips in inventories and he'll be looking for the demand forecast. And again, he'll be determining whether to order more chips or from the Intel or not. Okay, if the informations are being given, means he can decide whether you can have how many chips in the stocks or how many are there in demand as well as, and he can also think whether to order more chips from the Intel or not. Okay, and for all those things, this ITs will be utilized. Okay, and again, based by using this IT system, no, you can easily capture and analyze the informations. Okay, and just an example, like a major manufacturer, no, of computer workstations and the servers found that much of information on customer demand was not being used to set production schedules and inventory levels. Okay, the manufacturing group, no, if they are lacked in demand information, then again the demand visibility will be get affected and the making inventories and production facilities will become blind. Okay, if the informations are not given properly, means obviously my demand forecasting, no, that will get blind and I don't know how much inventories I should be have, and the production decisions will also be get blinded. Okay, if you are installing this IT in supply chain system, means the company, they can easily gather the information and they can easily analyze the data to produce the stocks. Okay, and the next topic is importance of IT in supply chain. What are the importance you will be having, means you can easily achieve the competitive advantage will be more. Okay, and the gathering and evaluating informations will be very easy. Okay, and again, with this information, no, you can make the reports. Report generations will be easy, and you can also get the, you can also make the decisions. Okay, and with this IT systems, no, you can coordinately make the process in supply chain. And the cost of information sharing will be very easy. The cost of information sharing will be very easy. And the responsiveness is, no, you can get the quick responses, even from the customer sides, as well as between the supply chain networks, no, the responses will be very quick. Okay, these are the importance of having IT in the supply chain. Okay. And the next topic is supply chain information technology in practices. Okay, we are going to see what are the practices they are having. Okay, electronic supply chains means ESC. Okay, this is actually the electronically managed supply chain. Okay, it's based EID based on or internet based. Okay, between the participants and the organizations, this is like on virtual supply chains. With based of in internet itself, they'll be having the suppliers transactions and the manufacturing process. Everything will be comes under the virtual process. That is actually the electronic supply chains. This practice they'll be following. And the next one is e-commerce. E-commerce means what is actually the e-commerce means? Like it's paperless business transactions, like paperless businesses. Yes, here no, by using email or fund transfers or electronic publishing, even the image processing, shared databases, whatever, no, whatever the businesses you are having, no, you can do it like with an electronic e-commerce, electronic commerce. And the e-procurement. E-procurement is like, here, no, what they'll be doing, instead of going directly to the suppliers and just asking and making the quotations and giving all those processes, by like in electronic system itself, they'll be doing the purchases. E-procurement is like electronic procurement, is like online purchasing. Okay. Here, what they'll be doing, no, wider purchase to pay. They'll be using this concept, like they'll be making the wide purchase and that time itself they'll be paying. Like that is the concept they'll be using it in e-procurement. Here, what are the value chains they are also following? It's like e-vendor management, e-tendering, catalog management, contract management. These are the things they'll be following. Okay. And next one is smart card. Smart card means like a plastic card with the traditional debit card or credit card dimensions will be there. Okay. Here, no, in which you can allow the information storage. Okay. If you want to know the information, means by using the smart card, you can know like how much data are there, how many stocks are there, everything you can know. That is actually the smart. And the next one is ERP. ERP, enterprise resource planning. Enterprise resource planning here is nothing but in organization, they'll be having like, just an example, like they'll be having a marketing department, HR department, human resource, like all the departments will be there, finance department, whatever. Okay. By having this ERP software, you can easily access what is happening in all other departments. Okay. Like today, like 500 shares are made booed out, means automatically it will be fed up and it will be fed in this ERP software. So by this, the finance team will be knowing like this much products is being moved out and this much of invoice has been cleared. All those things they can know. Again, from the inventory team, they'll be knowing like, okay, this product, 500 products are moved out. Again, we have to replenish. This inventory team, they'll be knowing. Okay, if the inventories are being stocked out, means what this manufacturers, they'll be doing purchase team, they'll be sourcing the resources. Okay, and how much resources, everything they'll be knowing, and from them they'll be making the product. Okay, this ERP software, it's a main hub for the organization. Same in supply chain, it's also a main hub. They'll be knowing the stocks and they'll be knowing what time the product is being moved out and what are the products get damaged and what are the resources are there from each and every department. They'll be knowing this activities. That is actually the ERP. These are the practices they are using in supply chain. Okay. Yes. Yes, everyone is there.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. And the next topic is coordination in supply chain. Okay, ma'am. Coordination in supply chain, that will actually helps to ensure what part of supply chain takes actions that will increase the supply chain profits and even how it's actions that improves coordinations. Okay, across each and different members in supply chain, they'll be resulting in the poor performance. If some coordinations are missing in the supply chain processes, means what will happen? That will obviously result in the poor performance, and even at each and every stage, they have to do their best. They have to work with their own objectives. Okay, the lack of coordination occurs either because different stages of supply chain have different objectives, or that actually they'll be having the conflict, or because the information's moving between the different stages, that will get disordered. Okay. And lack of coordinations will also result if the stage of supply chain, without considering the plan, without having the plan, then again the coordinations will miss, means the entire supply chain will be get lost. Okay. many of the companies know they have observed bullwhip effect, which means like they'll be having a fluctuations in the demand informations. Okay, with the different stages having very difficult estimates of what demands look like, means this will obviously result in loss of supply chain coordinations. Okay, again, what will happen? No, the bullwhip effect. No, this will increase the manufacturing cost, inventory cost, and even the replacement lead times. No, in supply chain, that will also get increased, and the labor cost, shipping cost will also get high. Okay, the bullwhip effect. No, that effect negatively affects the performance at each and every stage. And that will also affect the relationship between the stages of the supply chain. Okay, thus that will also affects each and every stages in the supply chain. Okay, and what are the causes for having this bullwhip? Means forecasting updating. Okay, multiple forecasting, multiple decisions you are taking. Like some will be telling like 10 demands are there. Some will be telling like 500 demands are there. Again, that will lead to the problem. Okay, if the forecast are not in proper way, means the updated. Some will be telling like before 2 years product, that is till that product they want, means what will happen? No, these peoples are not updated. They have not updated, means again that will get spoiled, and the order. Okay, each member of the chain, no, they'll be having own economics of skills, even in the transportation, even in the production. That will also lead to the ordering bash. Okay, and the price fluctuations. Some will be giving the discounts, or some will be giving the price promotions. Okay, for forward buying. Okay, thus that will also cause distortion. Okay, and this prices will be changing, no? That will affect the bullwhip effect. Okay, and then longer lead time. Longer lead time means if I'm just giving an order and I'm just want my product within the one week, but if you're giving my product within like 10 days, 15 days, means that will also affect the bullwhip effects. Okay. Okay, here this inventory cost, this bullwhip effect, no, will increases the inventory cost. To handle this increased demand, no, manufacturer has to carry high level of inventory. Then that would require the absence of bullwhip effect. Okay, transportation cost. If you are having the increased transportation cost, means again the fluctuations for the time will be changing. Again, what will happen in return? You need the more transportations. And if you want to cover the high demand products, means you are in need of high transportation cost. Okay.
Okay.
And I'm just telling, if the coordinations among the supply chains are very weak, means obviously these are the things it will be getting affected. And this comes under the coordination concepts. Okay. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. Okay, and the next one is how you are going to achieve this coordination. How managers can achieve this coordination, means first thing is aligning goals and incentives. What they'll be doing, no? The major key point for having this coordinations, no? They have to ensure that the objectives or any functions for decisions, no? That should be completely combined with the overall company's objective. Like all the facilities, the transportations, informations, the inventory decisions should be based upon their profits. not on the total cost or even the worst or just the local cost. Okay, this will helps to avoid the situations like transportation manager making decisions at lower transportation cost but increasing the overall supply chain. Everyone has to work with their main objective. Like a transportation manager, no, he wants to get lower cost means, okay, he can give at lower cost, but what will happen? The entire supply chain cost will be get higher. Okay, and the pricing for coordination. Pricing for coordination means here, no, what the manager has to use, no, like lot size bulk products they want to buy means they want to give the discounts for achieving the coordination. Okay, for the commodity products, if the retailers and the manager know they are having a large fixed cost means they have to give some discounts. Okay, for the products for which firm has market power means manager can use two parts of tariff, volume discounts to help coordinations. Okay, or they can give if the manufacturers, if the demands are not known means they can use buyback contracts. Okay, by having this buyback contracts, no, they can easily maximize the supply chain profits. Okay, and the next one is by improving the informations. Okay, sharing the point of sale data. Sharing the point of sale data means if what are the sales have been done and in today's how much sales have been made, like the past data. If I'm giving the good informations means obviously my coordinations among the supply chains will be proper. Like yes, today this much of sales have been done, like this flavors this much of sales have been more. If I'm just giving all the points of sale data in an accurate manner, the informations are in accurate manner means obviously my coordinations will be start increased. Okay. Okay. And the next one is designing of single stage control of replenishment. Here single stage of control of replenishment means what they'll be doing, no, in supply chain process. Single stage control replenishment decisions for the entire supply chain has to be done. Okay, if I'm going to fill all those inventories means I should be the single point for filling the inventories. If I'm has been appointed as an inventory manager means I should take care of all the process. Okay, like all the departments, whenever they can come and they can store the products, they can move the products means it completely collapsed. The data will not be in a proper way. Am I right? If work has been given to the one person means like to an individual team means they'll be taking care of only that work. Then they can easily give the proper data. Right, if that work has been given to 2 to 3 teams or 5 teams means what will happen, you cannot get the proper report, you cannot get the accurate data when the product has been moved and what is the slow moving product and what are the fast moving products, that will be get very difficult. Okay. Okay. And the next one is building a strategic partnerships and trust within the suppliers. How you can build up trust within the supply chains. Okay. What they'll be doing, no? A trust-based relationship between two stages means it will include the dependability of two stages. Okay. And the ability of each stage to make the faith. Trust means the faith of each stage if he is interested in others' welfare and would not take actions without considering the impact of other stage. Okay. If I'm just, how you'll be building the trust between the supply chain means like between the two stages, between the suppliers and manufacturers means he has to give the product, supplier has to give the product in a good quality. Okay, supplier has to give the product in a good quality to the manufacturer. If he is having the good faith means he'll be giving the product in a good quality. That will not affect the manufacturer's face, right? If the products are being given in a low quality means what will happen? Obviously, the entire product will not move in the market. Okay, so there the trust breaks. why that should not be happen means the both has to have a good cooperation and they should work within the supply chain, the trust should be there, and that will obviously improve the performance of the supply chain. Okay. Okay. And the last topic, ma. Key businesses in the supply chain. Okay. Key businesses in the supply chain here is like, what are the roles of e-businesses in the supply chain? This will know e-businesses, if you are having today, it's like internets are playing the major role in supply chain. Even for us, internets are playing a major role. And companies know they are using this internet to conduct a wide variety of supply chain transactions. By using the internet only, they are doing a lot of supply chain transactions. And the, what are the roles they are having in e-businesses? No, like it will be providing the product information. And it will also help in placing the orders with the suppliers. And it will also allow customers to place the orders. Okay. And it will also allow the customers to track the orders. Even filling, even delivering of orders to the customers, you can easily know. And receiving the payments from the customers, this e-businesses will be using. Yes. Okay. Here, no, like a business to business process and business to consumer process, what will know? From business to business commerce, no, when one business sells another, one business is no, they'll be selling to the another businesses rather to an end users. Okay, in e-businesses, what they'll be doing, no? One business people will be selling to the another business people rather than to the customers, like business to business transactions will be done. Okay. Here, business to consumer transactions, commerce means what they'll be doing. No, the transactions will be done between the company and the consumer. Okay. Here, the value for the he business, no, will allow the business to create the significant value to the futures also. Okay. And this value, no, however, will be depending upon the industries and the stages in the supply chain, how the companies are occupying. Okay. And this e-businesses framework, framework, no, it will have the impact on the responsiveness, like which will company's ability to grow or even the profit revenue. Okay. And even this will actually impact on the efficiency also. Okay. And the impact of e-businesses on responsiveness means direct sales to the customers. Okay. 24 hours of access from any locations you can access. And wide product portfolio, information aggregations you can have. Even the customization you can done. And faster time to the markets. Flexible prices you can get. And the product portfolio, even the promotions you can easily done. And the prices and the service discriminations you can done. Okay. Efficient fund transfers can be done, and even the convenience and the automated process will be done in e-businesses. Okay. Like Amazon's, no, they'll be having Amazon's, they'll be having the direct sales. The impact will be good and impact will be equal, but efficient fund transfers will also be there. Okay. And 24-hour access means, yes, 24-hour access you can get. But here, no, sometimes the lowest stocks will also be add, will be there. Like wider product portfolio means that will be there. But convenience will be equally impact. Yes. And the facilities will be more. The transportations here, no, it will be quite okay, like from far places, if you are giving means the amount will be more, transportation charges will be more. Yes, and you can have the price discrimination here. Okay. Okay. Here, the value from business to business transactions, e-businesses. Okay, here means you can easily have the search products. And identifying of availability and the pricing, you identify the substitutes also. You can here know the market efficiency will be improved. Okay, large number of buyers and sellers can be attracted to the online sites. Yes, and the supply chain benefits here is like the value of supply chain benefits can be done by higher when the product life cycles are short. Okay, firms know which can have a highest successful e-business. No, only if it is integrate the internet with the existing channels of distribution in the way like that uses the strength of each approximate. Okay, and the next one is e-businesses in the practice. E-businesses in the practice means it will actually keep the customers informed throughout the order. Okay, like if your product are being ordered means like what are the informations, what are the specifications, everything in the chain, everything will be listed out, and when the product are being shipped and when the product are being moved out, everything are being done in the e-business practices. Okay, and this optimizes the logistic to handle packages not on the pallets. Okay, and designing this e-business supply chain, no, it will efficiently handle the returns. They'll be handling the return products also. Okay, and this will integrate the internet with the physical networks also. Existing physical networks also, you can get this e-business practices. Okay, and the last one is financial decisions and supply chain. Okay. And the financial decisions in supply chain. Okay. Here means like impacts on individuals or families' well-being, no, that will actually decides the financial decisions, right? The way of being happy, healthy, and the prosperous, everything comes. Saving the families, saving money for family vacations and spending more money wisely and purchasing of new items. Everything comes under the financial decisions. Okay. And decision-making process. Yeah, no, you have to first step is if you want to make a good decisions. First step is you have to identify the problem. Okay. What are the problems are there and how you can rectify and what are the problems the competitors are facing? Everything, the problems are to be identified. Okay. And next thing is after identifying the problem, you have to identify the resources. Okay. Identify the resources. Like, okay, if I'm just going to make this product or if I'm just going to make this product or process, whatever, I should identify the resources, available resources. And based on that, I need to gather a lot of information based on those things. Okay. After gathering all those informations, no, I need to find the alternatives also. I need to find out the alternatives. Okay. Like if you're going to start the business with one options means that is not good. And every time you have to have some alternatives. You have to have some options. Without which I'm having just one mission and running my business means it's actually a foolish thing. Okay. Every time you should have the alternative things for uninterrupted productions. Okay. Again, after having the alternatives, no, I need to identify what are the advantages and disadvantages for taking in each and every options. Okay. Again, you have to put all those decisions. Okay. You have to put all those decisions into action. And you have to decide whether we can start this business or not, whether we can do this investments or not, whether we can make this decision for the further mode or not. After deciding, no, I'm just going to put this process and finally the outcome of the process, you are going to decide. Okay. These are the financial decision making processes. Okay. And what are the impact of having financial risk on supply chains means? Like the range of risk might be the economical, even the political, even the technical risk, even the environment disturbance that will also affect your finances on supply chain. Okay. And this risk no have a negative consequences in supply chain, like financial losses, reduced market share, even your company's reputations will also get damaged. Okay. And even in the growing trend in global financial instability, no, that will have the financial risk at center stage itself. Okay. And like the foreign exchange risk, this occurs means while dealing with foreign currencies, no, the conversion rates will also get supply chain cost. Okay. The default risk. Default risk means the firm is unable to meet the financial obligations, like inability to pay the contractual interest, credit transactions, nala, they'll be failing to pay their interest. Okay, the prices for the product or within the agreed time, no, they'll be failing to the pay the product, that pay the prices. That is also a default risk. Okay, and the market risk. Market risk means here, no, this market risk affects the overall market or the economy. Interest rate is nothing but the market risk. Okay. Okay. That's all. A supply chain topic has been gets over. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.